Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nitya, a retired lecturer in hermetology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Christianity is as simple as ABC, if you go logically. And here I'm doing the exposition of the miracle, or explaining the miracle of water and blood coming separate from the side of Christ Jesus. Water represent flesh or the once born people, and blood represent our spirit, the very spirit of our Father God. Because without blood you get gangrene or you die. No blood, you die. So flesh is useless. So the life of the person is in blood. So blood represents God as well. So I just described, you know, that this flesh is of natural father and it obeys the natural laws, born and die. But when you become the son of the Most High, supernatural Father God, are born of the blood, then you become eternal like our fathers, and you get resurrected. Reincarnation in Adam and resurrection in God. So I was just doing the how the rabbis became crook, you know, and then Jesus came and he had 12 apostles or laborers, now no disciples. The word disciple is from discipline. You discipline natural men, not spiritual. So the messianic Jew, they corrupted the whole gospel. So Jesus came to sort them up. So he had one of the laborer, Peter, whose original name was Simon, but he called him Peter because he was once born. He could not understand gospel, but he was truthful person, and he had the key to the kingdom of heaven that belongs to angels. So remember Christ Peter, because he was one of the inner circle laborers. So he was son of the supernatural father, son of the Most High. So he was greater than John the Baptist, even though he was not educated or had the knowledge of gospel or the Oral Torah. Still being truthful, and what is inside is outside, no hypocrisy, he became the Son of the Most High. So people don't need a gospel if they are truthful and they are not hypocrite. Then they are like Peter. Remember, Christ Peter had the key to the kingdom of heaven, which you see outside in law and order, that used to be belonging to the rabbis. And he killed two liars, Ananias and Saphira, because Christ Peter belonged to the supernatural royal kingdom of God. His subservient angels came to set him free in the prison of Herod. Remember, he was freed from the prison by an angel. So he came to serve him, you know. Thus, liars are rotten eggs in the churches of God. One true fold, Church of God, headed by one shepherd, Christ Jesus, not too like Church of England, headed by Queen, and also they say Christ. They are very clever people, and I asked this Archbishop Roman, you know, that you have two heads, which one you serve, Mammon or God? Oh, Queen is just governess, she is not the head of the Church of England. See, in his heart he knew what is the truth and what, how they are twisting this fact, you know, to bypass. So their hearts are not clean, not like little children. They are hypocrites. So that's why they suffer, you know, they can't get gospel. You need a clean heart for gospel to rest or Christ to come inside. The temple of, this is the temple of God, Emmanuel. So if you're not truthful, Christ can't rest in your heart. He will be out. Satan will be resting. So they are hypocrites, you know. Now we deal with blood, you know. This raw water, pitcher, physical body, without the Spirit of God is dead. That means without blood, you know, in us, we are dead. We get gangrene and then we get low blood count and all that. So to train the life-giving roving priests, or the royal priests, the Christ, Jesus had 12 inner circles at the core of his heart, laboring sons of the Most High God, which is Spirit. Further, as the moral laws are not compatible with the spiritual principles, remember that the moral laws don't apply to God or spiritual men. To them apply the righteousness of God. Because spiritual men, like God, you know, is purely spirit. So the laws do not come from God. We are to do what comes from God. No law is made by God. Because if the laws are made by God, God has to go by those laws. Otherwise, he will be a hypocrite. So he states the spiritual principles, which are his word. Then it is up to the men to fashion or coin the moral laws as a shadow of that principle. So that is how the moral laws are coined. That's why Jesus could explain the roots of the moral laws to the rabbis in the temple. And so we can. Moral laws are not compatible with the spiritual principles of our supernatural Father God. The laborers being trained as the roving preachers, called the royal priests, who, unlike the laws of Moses, based upon tit-for-tat, they present the other cheek, or they go by the Sermon on the Mount, in which you hit not the physical body of the person, but his conscience, so as to awaken him. Because in this is the temple of God, inside is the God himself lives there. So if we hit the temple, then we're hurting the one who's inside is God. So in Jesus, we don't hit back. We present the other cheek. So then if he has conscience, then he will become your friend. Like Jesus, when he was in the temple, and the rabbi was asked, the temple high priest was asking him question, but he was keeping his mouth shut because it's no good to talk to somebody who is imposing his own views or who is authority. So you keep quiet, you know, and somebody hit him on the cheek, face. Don't you know that you are not answering to the temple high priest. And temple high priest became furious by torning his frock and other thing, as if he is very much, you know, furious. And those people standing nearby, they say, hey, our temple high priest is very furious. They became also furious. They hit him on the face. Then Jesus asked him politely, for what wrong have I done that you hit me on the cheek? But the man has no conscience. He was saltless. If he had the salt of Abraham, then he would have conscience. Being a Jew outwardly, he was saltless, son of Satan. So no reply, no conscience. So sons of Satan always kill the saints. And sons of Satan are killed by the sons of man, as during the Holocaust in Germany. When the German became German, they killed Jews. And when the English were English, they killed Jews. America was a haven for them because there was no tribal majority there. And blood coming out separate. Sorry. This happened to the soldiers. Moral laws are not compatible with the spiritual principle of our supernatural Father God. The laborers being trained as the roving preachers called the royal priests, who, unlike the laws of Moses based upon tit-for-tat, they present the other cheek, or they go by the Sermon on the Mount, in which you hit not the physical body of the person but his conscience, so as to awaken him. This happened to the soldiers who nailed Jesus to the cross under the orders of their king, Pilate. But when they saw the miracle of water and blood coming out separate, water forgiving their sins of nailing Jesus to the cross, and blood sprinkles, and the blood sprinkles made them twice born of spirit. Then they realized that he was a prophet, accused by the Jews, accused by the Jews falsely. But it was too late. Thus the inner circle, 12 laborers, were trained by Jesus for the ministry of heart, the seat of Christ in the temple of God. This is the temple of God, our physical body. Heart is the source of the oral Torah, the gospel. They were not bound by the moral laws, but by the righteousness of heart. This is the same as the Gentiles were going by. The laws or moral laws of the Gentiles were written over their hearts and not in the books. So they were living in spirit. And no wonder they were already in the royal kingdom of God. Remember that there's a parable of 100 sheep. One got lost. Then he left the 99 sheep on the hill to look after themselves, because when you are under the protection of God, there's nothing to be worried. The Gentile were under the protection of God. Christ Philip said, a Gentile never dies, for he does not live to die. In other words, they found the 99 sheep, and the one that was missing or lost was the chosen people, especially of the Judah tribe. They were the most standing people of Judah tribe. That is where the Jew and Judah became synonymous. They made the Jews outwardly, not inwardly. So they are the greatest sons of Satan, the tares, and hope their chief prime minister or so, he is not of Judah tribe. He should be of Judah tribe, you know. That is why before the end of the world. Of Judah tribe, that Jesus went for to redeem, but they killed him instead. You know, when Jesus went there to redeem them, he carried them over his shoulder in honor and not give them a whip. Why were you lost? No, with love. Come. But they killed him. He gave them all the service, cured their lepers and sick people, and told these Gentiles, no, I have come for the Jews. Give them the preference, you know. And what they did him, they killed him. The 12 worked. The 12 worked for our father as royal, as his royal priest, to glorify him in mercy, and died trying to redeem people into the royal kingdom of God, which is inside us, for rest or resurrection. So when you are son of the Most High, then you become like our father. Lazarus was a practical demonstration that Jesus gave. Dead for 4 days, he was revived, he was resurrected. And so that was a practical example of resurrection. He was friend of Jesus. Friend is, you know, when Jesus had first laborers picked them, and then when they start understanding, he told them, we have one Father, God. They were brethren. As they became more philosophical, then Jesus called them friends. They were no more brethren, but friends. Friends is a higher status than brethren. Thus, the kingdom of heaven that belongs to our heavenly Father Yahweh, Brahma or Khudah in Arabic, is of works or karma, and it is outside in law and order. You can see it is seen in law and order for the comforts of our physical body. Now ask these people in Gaza Strip, where is hell and heaven? They will tell you. Our Syrian people, which these tears are causing a hell over there. Whilst the royal kingdom of God is within our hearts, within the hearts of the royal priests of our supernatural Father God, that is to be perceived in merciful deeds. You perceive, you don't see it. That is what applies to flesh and the priests of Moses. The opposite applies to the spirit and the royal priest of anointed royal high priest Christ Jesus. That is why the outer circle 70 laborers of the kingdom of heaven of Yahweh water were kept separated from the inner core laborers of God, life-giving blood, the royal priests of God. Promotion of Mathias from the outer circle to the inner circle was a promotion from the priests of Moses to the roving royal priests of God. And also it stresses that the ideal rabbis are supposed to be knowledgeable of the word of God, which is the Oral Torah, as the Samaritan woman had well reflected the qualities of the rabbis serving the Gentiles. She was a saint, you know, and these Jewish messianic people, they hate Samaritans, and they call her, she was a bad woman, marrying one husband after the other, whereas they were spiritual husbands. And I put a link under in the description, which you can copy. Thus, the priests of Moses are rulers over their disciples, whilst the royal priests are super servants of their brethren, whether male or female in flesh, under one father. Further, as the Christ Peter was in charge of the kingdom of heaven for the truthful tribal sons of man, so he used to give the first sermon in the churches, and then afterwards the apostles used to sow the seed of his word in the hearts of gospel truth-seeking congregations. So I will leave it here, and then we'll finish with the rest in the next video.